Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Reytac back with, this is gonna be like episode 16. Just finished a two-run attempt, a two-recorded-run attempt. I made it down to the second floor twice, and died both times. As a pilot. So we're playing the convict here. The convict has faster fire, so... we'll see how things go. I feel like I'm tilting a bit. I mean, on stream in one run, I managed to get down to the final floor of the game, and I haven't done that since. And, well, some of that is because we got really good stuff on that one run we did get down there. It shouldn't be impossible. We've had some pretty good runs, but other than that, I just haven't been able to make use of them. This is Table Tech Sight. Clip Multiplier. Okay, this ancient technique briefly increases gun output whenever the table is flipped. So, when you flip a table, you basically get 20-20. Is, I think, what this equates to. Why was there a veteran shotgun can? That was the water barrel. Ooh. The 38 special for the Inquisitor. I like it. I'll stick with the budget revolver, for now at least. So yeah, actually, it gives us a shot. Yeah, it gives us a triple shot when we flip the table. So it's pretty nice. Pretty nice stuff. You have to play better. So, the triple shot effect remains for a few seconds after you finish the time slow, so pretty good to know. Ooh! We got a lot of fancy shooters down there! Alright, hopefully our boss on this floor is somebody who can get punished by the Molotov. Which means Gatling Gull or the Trigger Twins. Alright. Hopefully we'll also be able to put that to better use than the acid that we got on the last floor, which ended up not working out for us. I mean, the only time we really used it was against the holster, and I kinda got shit on against him. That was my fault. Nope. Wow, we picked up a lot of HP drops on this floor. We'll just go ahead and ignore that for now. Another chest. We found the shop. We have not found the shop. Hmm, interesting. Alright, so we found the 38 special. No. My aim sucks. I might consider doing it if there's no key for sale, but I flip over the tables. I feel like you should be able to go up that. I flip over the tables even when there's nothing going on. Just because I like flipping over the tables, it makes me feel like I'm doing something as I just travel through the rooms. And sometimes just feeling like you're doing stuff is pretty important. Now, note, I am actively ignoring the thought of, oh, it's a cursed salesman. Why are your items cursed? Why are heart items accursed? Give me the key. I'll figure out why. Oh, I didn't mean to pick that up. Oh. Really now? Really?
Right. So, if we can somehow pick up two keys on the rest of this floor, we might be able to go down to the Oubli-let. Is that likely? I don't think so, quite honestly. But, I mean, I didn't even think we'd be able to go get the fire put out on this floor, so you never know. Though the fact that we did get a key from pretty much our last room doesn't bode well for the chances of that. Now, we could get a key from the boss fight, could get a key from whatever this room up here is. And I do think that I can say with some certainty that green flames. Okay, so here's our, here's the big room, the flame room. Oh hey, it's actually giving us another enemy. But it didn't give us a key. So let's just put out the fire. Now that opened up way down there. But we can't do anything about it. So we're just gonna go to the boss. I'm gonna switch to the 38 special. Let's do this. And of course, it's the Bullet King, the one enemy who can't be fucked over by our fire. Like, look at that. He's standing in it. Okay. This time I need to remember that the flame spiral actually, or that one, the shot spiral does, oh, spiral. So this is essentially the budget revolver. The difference is it has 6 shots instead of 5. And on the other side, okay. Now I wish that at least did some kind of like contact damage to it. Bad time for my nose to be itching. Alright, he's almost down. And dead. Alright. We didn't flawless him. We took a couple hits. And we got Scattershot? Scattershot. Scattershot is an interesting one. We'll go pick up this HP. Move down to the next floor. We didn't even pick up one key, so. Now, Scattershot is actually one of the items I think I had on the run that did get pretty far. Do you have anything I could consider? I mean, you've got a blank for 10, but. Pick up another armor. And call it done. Wait, does this give our Mega Dowser 3 streams? That's hilarious. One note about Scattershot is that it does not deal a third of the damage. Like, one bullet does not deal a third of the damage. So you don't need, like, 9 bullets to kill a simple bullet can. You need, like, 4, I think, 4 or 5. So, I mean, you get triple the bullets, but not a third of the damage. Pardon me. I feel that one coming in. It was hurting. Yeah, we're gonna do this. This is ridiculous. We're just gonna bathe this land in water. So I think he was being kept from shooting by the fact that we were pretty much consistently hitting him. Ooh, no sir. Look at this. This is hilarious. Alright. All y'all, keep y'all distant. Now, the Mega Dowser does not deal the world's most damage in the first place, so I'm not surprised that it's taking a lot of ammo to kill even- I thought that was a doorway for some reason. It's taking a lot of ammo to kill even simple enemies, but I still love the triple stream thing we've got going on here. And the fact that, like, when enemies are being hit, they don't seem to attack. I mean, we just used, like, 100 rounds in this one round. Now, I picked up Scattershot because I do actually like it, despite the fact that it nerfs us so much. Okay, we're... Yes, run next to the scary guy who predicts you and has screwed over your runs before. Okay, that sniper. Why is that's like a veteran sniper? That's a friggin' veteran sniper. Maybe it is a third of the damage. Are you up here, Sunball? Hang on. I think there's something about... Nope. For some reason, I thought that he would, like, take extra damage from that. I don't know. Well, let's go back and pick up his HP. No reason not to. And let's explore this way real fast. Oh, hey. So if we can get a key, we can get an HP, a blank, and a chest. I don't think that would be worth it. Alright, let's go back. Seriously, I think that's probably one of the most underutilized aspects of this game. Heavy boots, not worth it. Key, how much is the key? 30. Ugh, okay. Now, I'm not even risking pulling the trigger in there, because I... Woo! Okay! That was a little dicey. I think because this thing shoots 3 times... sit down, sir. I'm worried that, like, consider it shooting 3 times for him, for purposes of him not wanting to be in there. Okay. Damn it, I'm never sure about what to actually do in that room. I've only seen it, like, once off camera. Well, it was an action off camera run, it was an on camera run, but, I mean, it had a mimic in it. But that was the on camera run that had a mimic. And I turned around and shot the mimic. Okay, I think I got lucky there. You guys are annoying. Alright. What's up? How did she do that? The dog is not a blanket. Did you grab her tail or something?
No, I grabbed
her
face.
Oh.
Actually,
come on. Huh. Alright, so that was my girlfriend. On the map it says there's still a mirror and a chest in there, but you can't actually do anything. So, yeah. Okay, you. Now, I desperately want to find a better gun than the... Oh, I was actually trying to use the sawed-off there. Because, I mean, the sawed-off, its potency has never been in its, damage? It's always been about the spread. So, I mean, the fact that we've got triple the spread... I mean, it should be a good thing? Doesn't seem like it, though. Oh my god, this is a grind. We are grinding for this run. Okay, I want to test something real fast. Okay, we shoot 3. Okay, so it's just adding 2 bullets? So that's what it is. That makes more sense. Rather than tripling the amount of shots we have, it adds 2. Oh, this is gonna be hellish. Okay. I need to actually make use of your computer. We took him out in one hit when we were close in. Get out of my face, sir. Okay, so we're at 33. Can't get that. But we can come back here and get a key. Now, I'm actually going to go up to this room. Because this room not only has an item in it, or something in it, it has HP and like. We just got more HP. I mean, hey, we got more HP. Not as good as finding, you know, maybe an HP upgrade. But we've now got 4 friggin' HP. Or 4 freaking blanks, look at that. Whoa. We don't have to be in that room ever again. So what? We use the sod up on the boss? I think we might have to. Scarily enough. Unless I can shoot one of those other chests or get a key from something. Yeah, no, I think if, wait, how did that hurt me? I'm not entirely sure. We got the map. I mean, yay, map. But, boo, map, rather than a gun? Or, you know, something along the shooty-shooty lines? I should have waited for him to shoot. I don't know why I thought he would stop charging up his attack when I was on the side. They've never done that. That has never been understood. So we are almost out of 38 special. So that's gonna be fun. I thought I hit the thing while I was hidden. Apparently not. Honestly, we have no reason. Come over here, roll. We'll switch to the budget revolver. Activate this. We'll come get this HP then sitting in here. That's probably the good thing about the map. Lovely. We can't even get that. Let's just go fight the boss. I guess we're gonna use the sawed-off on our second floor boss. Who is the Amoconda, so we're also gonna burn this punk. And, you know, blank in as much as we can. I mean, we did have three No. Out of the corner. Corner is probably the worst place to be. Right now the center of the room's not that good of a place either. Because of the oh come on. You can't dodge that fast. The game expects you to play well, which I'm apparently not doing now that I'm fighting a boss with the friggin' sawed off. And you sawed off. And I'm dead. Amoconda. We're gonna return to the breach. We're going to play as the Marine, because that is who I seem to actually consistently do fairly well with. We got 6 hegemony credits, so we'll come up here and we'll see if you guys have anything. We have the M16. Find me down the way and I might just have that for you. M16, look at that. Oh, and it's got a grenade launcher on it. That's beautiful. We now have 1 hegemony credit. And we need to see those two. Apparently, those two are like, they're just roaming around down there now. I want to find out what they're down there for. I've been watching Northern Lion play, but I haven't actually like really been paying attention. Like today, I was listening to them while I was at work and not actually watching. So, not entirely sure what people are around for yet. Right, so the Marine. What's good about the Marine? The Marine starts with armor. The Marine starts with a magazine that puts 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 rounds in. Fairly accurate, he apparently has the high reload, or faster reload for guns. Ooh, water barrel, so we now know where the water barrel is. And I've actually consistently done decently well with the Marine. So, I mean, I'm happy to see the Marine. And I have now played all of the other characters. Woo! Since the last time I played the Marine, I mean, I finished my problem somehow. Okay. Someone else in here? Hi, buddy. Okay. So we want to find... That's tempting, but that requires 2 keys. We need, like, 4 keys to do everything on this floor. 5, maybe 6 keys to do everything we want to on this floor. Are we going to fight the boss? Not yet. I mean, if we can't get another key at some point... It's not worth it to try not to get the, it's worthless to try getting the stuff for the Oubli-let done. But, let's try to get a second key. And then maybe consider... What are you? The Helix. And the key is 40, is 25, and the Helix is like 45. Oh, hi! I did not see you. Okay, so we're now at 23, if this shell ever catches up to me. I don't know what causes some enemies to drop shells and others not to. Maybe? Okay, focus on the guy who can actually hurt you rather than just move. Okay, killed a Gini in a couple hits. 5th up as a bonus. Chest there. Okay. Wow, boss is actually the closest teleport to where we need to go to continue. So, down to the boss. Alright, we need a table tech. We've got a lot of tables, but no, nothing to do with them. Now, I'm not buying the second key yet. One, because we haven't even seen the fireplace. This might be it. And two, because there's still a chance that... How did you guys find this room? Oh! Two, we might find another key, and if I can find another key, I'd like to try to... Don't walk in the door. Don't walk in the door. Okay, grenades. Yeah, when there's a bunch of spawns like that, it's usually a bunch of grenades. With maybe some of them. Okay. Anyway, what I was going to say is that I'd like to try to save up the money and possibly get that Helix, which I have not seen. Period. I haven't seen or heard somebody else get it. I haven't seen it used. Could be a stellar weapon. Could be a crap weapon. Okay, we do have enough for the Helix. We have not gotten another key, though. Also, I do not want to have to travel 3 fucking years to the water barrel to try to get the Oubli-let open. Okay, where's our fire room? Okay, so this room here has the water barrel. What room has the fireplace? We have the architecture of a fireplace room. I think it was this one here. Over here. Nope, that is not. This one, maybe. Oh, I'm not sure which one is the fireplace room. Quite honestly. You? No.
Oh, let's see if we actually have a fireplace anywhere. Oh, it's this one. Right? Was it this one? I'm gonna be pissed if I have to try to get the water barrel all the way over here. This is not a fireplace. This is the fireplace. Okay. Alright, let's do this. Bump. Bump. Down. Okay. Now I move down here, intercept with my face. Bump. No. You keep going. I was just trying to be smart and get in front of you. Okay. Ooh. Come up here. All the way to here. Stop. No, keep going. And we've got the fireplace. Where did it spawn? Down there. Alright, let's go fight the boss. Are we fighting the boss with just the screen starter pistol? Is it the trigger twins? Yes and yes. Why did I ask if it was the trigger twins? I feel like the trigger twins are probably the ones I have the best chance of crossing. Not sure why I feel that way. Maybe because I flawlessed them on our last run. Or last episode. Not on the last run. Last run we had bullet king. Could have dodge rolled. Oh, really? Probably should not do what I'm doing and try to fight a boss with the starter pistol only. It tends not to work out for you. Hey now. Oh, bad time for a life spike. Oh, why did I get pushed back? That's bad. Okay. In retrospect, should I be trying to do this? No. But hindsight is 20/20, I swear to God. You get within spitting distance of this stupid Oubli-let again. Now, so you get their guns. Like, you can pick up their guns. I wonder if it would be possible to, like, get these alternate fire modes that some of their guns have. Lovely. An ammo box. But we did get a key. We got the mailbox. Shoots letters and then a package. Come back here. Pick up the helix. I'll get you out of a jiffy. Come over here. Pick up this HP so we're not kissing death. So it shoots two bullets. First shot, that wiggle. Hello, I would like that health, please. Okay, before we leave, we'll shoot these chests and maybe pick up something from them. Maybe pick up HP? You can get HP from a chest. Maybe have them explode in your face and try to kill you. That's a possibility too. The world is our oyster, and these chests are the shell. That is junk. That is not something you want. Alright, let's turn the helix up. Down we go! Yay! We're on the bonus level, baby! Bonus level, baby! Oh god, I need to stop trying to sing. It does not work out
Oubli-let, chamber triple question. Wait. Oh, mutant bulletkins. I was like, why did he get poisoned? Mutant bulletkins, bat poison, it's not our human gun. Okay, charge down a breakthrough corridor. Okay, so the Helix gun seems alright. Except for the fact that you have to... Really, you kind of just have to get lucky that the enemy is in the cross point. No. I'm on the other side of the map. I call bullshit. Okay. Letter gun! That package is explosive. Cool. I kind of think that that might actually be our weapon that we want to get from the boss when we get there. Simply because it's, the package is high damage. That's really it. Okay, what have you got, buddy? You got anything cool? What is that? That is the M1911. Pretty good weapon. Ooh, what's your key for? 30. Okay. Okay, nope, you're too close! Damn it, I just got that HP. Okay, so the Helix gun is trash. Let's stick with the marine sidearm. Why do we stick with the marine sidearm? Because I'm... Oh, that's my answer. What are you... Do you always come out of these, junked up blobby arms? Maybe you do and I just killed you with the explosion on that one. Not sure. I want you. I don't need you, but I want you. Okay. So, the package is poison apparently? Package like a drain effect. That time it did. That time it exploded really. Okay, so spogers are immune to poison. Which makes it really not useful that both of those triggers are poison. Okay, we will warp back here. I hate to do this, but I can't bear the thought of dying. I'm a half heart. Should have saved up the extra two shells credit. What do we call them? For the whole heart, it would have been better. But we also could have died on it. Especially because there's a veteran bullet kit. I figured out an easy way of, like, getting past the veteran bulletkin. Really, I'm just thinking this now. Oh, this one. Okay. I remember this. You just have to run. Yes. Kill yourself for me. Might be the boss actually over here. No. I don't want to die here. Oh, I'm in a corner. I am in this glass cage of emotion. We could have been dead if I hadn't bought that HP. I would have been dead if I hadn't bought an HP. Also, would it kill the game to give me a damage? Mutants are immune to poison. So are genes. Whoa. Would it kill the game if it gave me a key? Okay, I'll give you a key right now. You just had to survive one more room after asking. Give me flame hand. Had this on my last run. We didn't really use it that much. It's piercing, fire damage. Not very powerful. Are we gonna make it? Nope. Am I going to try? Yes. Am I just gonna burn the shit out of everything? Yes. Okay, so there's a cell down here. You are a lock inside a lock. You are locked inside of a... Not questioning it. You know what? We're gonna keep using the mailbox because... Ooh. Ooh, and there's armor. Oh, but it's locked. Gunmuncher, you are totally eating the helix. The helix sucks.
Muncher, it looks like it can use another gun.
Okay. You know what? We're just gonna do this now. I'm not gonna risk it. What are you giving me for my piercing fire weapon? A pitchfork. You give me a pitchfork. You've given me a non-piercing fire weapon for my piercing fire weapon. Let's do this, son! Okay, it's the giant blob again. Okay, the giant blob is not taking much damage from our fire. I would have been hit there. Now, this thing reloads in like a second. Oh, those moves are bullshit. Okay. The M16 has joined the shootout. Alright. Restart. Is the Oubli-let worth it? If you can go down in good condition. Yes. I.e., you can get another gun somehow that holds things down for you. I.e. don't go down using only the starter pistol. Is the helix worth it? Oh god, sweet mother mercy, no. I'll take an extra blank though. Have to get better. That's the only solution. Because this is not a game where, like, honestly, luck, while luck has some say in the Gungeon, as opposed to something like Nuclear Throne or Binding of Isaac, not so much. In this game, I will definitely say that technical skill, playing well, knowing the enemy patterns and being able to avoid being hit is so much more critical than luck is. Because, oh boy, bullet hell bosses become much easier when you know, oh, if you stand at exactly this angle and part three times, you will never get hurt. So this game does reward like repetition, rewards practicing, finding your enemies, learning them. We have 32 shells, and we're gonna have like 40 something after we get this gun nut. Should die here, yep. Hey, we will have 42. I'm fairly certain that the silver silver shells. Yeah, 44 because we picked up two. Okay, another. Oh, I did not see you there. Our perseverance, we now have 4 links and 44 shells. Alright, we're making good time here. Not yet. Tempting. But we should at least try to see if we can find a fireplace and a water barrel. Okay, no water barrel in this room. Oh, he went off half off. Not good for him. No water barrel. Water barrel. Double vision. Double vision. Goodbye. One for each of you. Double vision. Double vision might make the starter pistol a godsend. And another key. Oh, we're... Is this our run? And the water barrel is only 2-3 rooms away from... This could be our run. Because there is a key for sale in the shop. We've been getting money like crazy. We could actually get enough money to buy the key. Oh no. How much is the key? How much is your key, sir? Oh, give me your note. Thanks for the ammo drop, chump. RR. Excuse you. Go. Okay, we're gonna move the table. You actually do have to flip tables to move them, which is hilarious. Somehow the same thing weighs less? Oh hey, there's another water barrel. Oh, I'm so glad there's another water barrel, because fuck that! Oh, come on. Oh, that hurts. Okay. Now, double vision might make the starter pistol actually a boss killer. That's why I'm not bemoaning this. Okay, where did it open up? I will. Okay. Okay. Double vision, you're my friend. Double vision, you're so awesome. I was blanking just to see if it was a secret room there. It was an off chance. It's junk. That's fine. I hate myself anyway. The Oubli-let, I don't know, really know if it's worth it, honestly. You're losing minimum 2 items. And if you can't get another key, you really have lost 2 items because Gatling, go. Okay, we're gonna save our double vision for when he flies, trying to get his maximum, or when he's trying to hit us with all of his freaking missiles. This. Because this is when we can do the most damage to. Okay. Doing okay. Oh. Weep. Keep your distance. Double vision is almost recharged. Whew. Okay, he was shooting from behind where he was.
Oh, we did it.
Oh. Oh, and that gave us... Not only did it give us a key, it gave us... It gave us enough money to get another key. Okay. Okay. Buy the key. That will get you out of jam. Yes, it will. Come over here. Say so long and thanks for all the fish. Double vision plus the M1 is going to be phenomenal for killing bosses. We had the M1 before. It was a great weapon. I did have it on the run where I had scattershot, so its potency was vastly reduced. But the M1 Garand is just... Like, I have read the information before, but it's supposedly one of the premier guns, and the Gungeon is supposedly waiting for its arrival. What the hell is going on in this room? Oh my god. Get poisoned, son. Seriously, being able to double your gun output, and unlike our shroom friend, ooh, hi, buddy. Unlike our shroomy friends there, we can accommodate for that. Now, the M1 Garand has piercing, it's powerful, has 6 shots or so, I think. It's just a wonderful, wonderful weapon. Yeah, 6 rounds. Watch us. Oh, come on. Open up. It one shots the spores. Oh, are there 2 of these guys? Yes. Come on, buddy. Open up. So good. Also, it's piercing. It's piercing seems to be like all of the Enter the Gungeon piercing, where it's not piercing like Binding of Isaac, where it just keeps going and going and going. That was a startling amount of money. It's piercing in that it goes through one enemy and then stops. Okay. Did not like that. Had to do it, did not like it. Okay. We done it? Not done. Oh, there was a guy behind me. That could have been bad. And we got HP. We found the shop. Let's go check it out. There is the junk guy. So, that is not what I meant to hit. I meant to hit this one. Drop. Drop. Get some money. Now, do we want the grappling hook? No. We really don't. We want the half heart. And now we're back at full HP. Should I have bought that? Probably not. Would it be the smart thing? No. Saving money would probably be the smart thing. I am not a smart man. I am a safe one sometimes. I'm just gonna stay here and move along. Alright, we're looking for chests, we're looking for exactly that, and we got bouncy bullets back. Hi, buddy. It's almost like it never left. And we got the shield, the champion thing, which gives us that special HP, or the special armor, which I don't know what it's for. It's probably for something like that. The fact that it's red armor has some kind of special consequence. I just don't know. Try talking to someone with it, because I mean, it does seem to have some kind of special significance, I just don't know what. Maybe we have to play really, really well, and get down to the 5th floor with that, with the merchant that's supposed to be down there, who wants you to, like, bring the stuff, like, the prime Hey look, it's HP. Maybe we have to buy the other HP? Nope. Do I regret it? Nope. Okay, so this room is fucked. Oh, come on! The game lagged me off of the stupid thing. Are you serious? Am I just going to get hit twice there because fuck me? Yes. Yes. Really, I did get hit twice there just because fuck me. Did those bullets, like, follow me? Anybody else? I feel like those bullets tried to follow me. I'm just firing in this mess. Oh, I know what it is. Okay. So kind of like the Bullet King's bullets travel in a circle, Spinny McSpin face over here, his bullets travel in a circle. And I just happen to be at the outside arc. Wow, hey, is more stuff. I don't feel like this room's gonna be harder than the blob boss, but I did just die to the blob boss, so maybe I don't know what I'm talking about. Okay, ooh. Why are some of the spores chasing me? Okay, you know what? We'll travel down. Say fuck you to those bullets that are still trying to chase us. I'm gonna come up here and pick up this HP. Yeah, that HP. Pick it up. Good stuff, man. I wanna move on with our lives. I honestly thought that the boss chamber would be like right here. Which doesn't make sense since we haven't seen any of the special rooms other than the shop. Like, we haven't seen either of the treasure chests that are on this floor. I should have known. I should have known that this floor wasn't done with us. The reason why I'm saying that is because I was trying not to use double vision. Because I was like, oh, the boss chamber's gonna be right here. No, it's not. I picked up another key. Now sitting at two keys on what is essentially the second floor with 37 shells. Life is good. Veteran shock again. Oh, right. So I don't think I ever finished explaining the way that I was like, maybe this would work for dealing with veteran shotgun. They try to predict your movement. So stay still until they shoot at you and then move around the street. Because unlike Bulletkin, Veteran Shotgun can shoot from the rest. Now, I am not suiting action to word here, simply because the Veteran Bulletkin was not alone, or Veteran Shotgun was not alone. There was a lot of other crafted units in the chamber. And I might have tried standing still if he was alone. All the other fucks that were about, it would have probably led to my demise. Okay, so we found the boss. We have not, however, found what's beyond this blocked door down here. It's probably our item, if I had to make a guess. Oh my god. Oh my god. Okay. Calm down. Ignore the frame stars. You can handle it. This is no big deal. Veteran Bulletkin is slightly annoying, but no big deal in the end. And the Mutant Shotgunner is dead. You have 44 shells, 2 keys, and a long hallway. That's not a long hallway. I was trying to bounce the shot around the corner to deal with him. I don't think it worked. One shot. Alright, who's up here now? Worked for me. That's one of the beautiful things you can do with bouncing bullets. Ricochet around corners. Give me something. Oh, the Luxon Cannon. Oh, I actually really like the Luxon Cannon. Okay, do you have anything cool? You have a key. Buy a key. Do we have anything to give to you? I think we already did. Yeah, we already did. We're gonna come over here. We're gonna switch to the M1 Garand. We're gonna go bring it on, blob bitch. Bring it on, blob bitch. And right click and go. I just realized that this might actually be better. Because of its extremely high fire rate and the final shell that comes out. Okay, that one's weird and I don't like it. I'm gonna go see it again. Okay, don't die to the blob twice in the same episode. Oh hey, he burst apart. Blobby Lord. Die, Blobby Lord, die. Okay. That did not go well for me. Pick up ammo for the Luxon. Pick up homing bullets, fire, and heat. Are you telling me my bullets are homing? Are you telling me my bullets are homing? Yes, please. Yes, please. I would like some more. Homing bullets, fire, and heat. First invented by the Grey Mouser to cheat at one of Winchester's games. Though Winchester eventually caught on and revealed his targets to appear friendly, these bullets are still exceptionally useful. Bouncing ricochet. Boom! Bouncing homing bullets. I would say so long as I am aiming in the general direction of the enemy, this is going to be a win here. For sure. And if I can line two enemies up, all the better. No. Who else is there? Alright. I'm using the M1 as a room clearer because... No. I'm not going to do anything. This room clears itself. Extra blank for it. We're now at 3 blanks. Nope. Ooh, that gap's a bit impressive. Okay. The ricochet, or the homing is actually working against me there. No, no. None of you get the deal. I'm not dealing with that. Five? Oh, so good. Selkie, ammo, full ammo. I was just thinking, if we can get to that shop, I might. Not dealing with that room. No thank you. Actually, we might want to consider buying HP. What are you? Pulse cannon. Scope. So good at room clearing. You are the lock inside of a lock. My rescuer! I knew you had no choice but to vanquish my fellow lock to free me. An unfortunate sacrifice, but a necessary one. Come by my shop whenever you see me. There are many things in my stores that you might find helpful. Cool. Okay. I'd actually like to find some item rooms. I have three. three keys? And so far nothing to spend the three keys on. Now, pulse cannon with the homing should be godly. Like, I should never miss if I'm aiming anywhere near them. And this is a killer much like our M1 is. Actually, I'm going to stick with the M1. Ooh, no. I do not want to go up against the second floor boss with only two rounds, or two HP. Now got four keys. You gave me, ooh, Smiley's revolver. That's actually pretty damn good. I'm having to dig. I'm definitely digging for this run, but it's working. Anyone else? Any other takers? No? Okay, that's a shield. I would have to give up my double vision for that. That's not happening. Yep, a rat's taking it, and it's about to disappear on the minimap. Alright. Honestly, we're looking for HP, we're looking for armor. Ooh, frames are dipping down. Not sure why. Alright, we're at 11 shells. I don't think we can buy even just the half heart. Nope. Alright, I guess we're going to fight the boss like this. I'll use pulse cannon. It's Medusa. You get out of the water. I got hit because I wasn't paying attention. Alright, Luxon's control. No. Nope, this is actually not like homing like I thought it would. Okay. No! I tried to hit spacebar and it didn't work out. Oh! That run would have been so good too. I just need to play better. Alright. That's going to be it for this episode. This is Reytac signing on out. In conclusion, the Oubli-let, worth it if you can make it work. Like, if you can get down there with something that is more powerful than the starter pistol, go for it. Otherwise, stay away.